starting it on the way to go hunting Kodiak. It's horrible over here, hopefully it's good over there. We're at the ferry terminal, leaving a couple hours. So exciting. Still waiting on the ferry to get off. Been waiting for an hour. They're loading, what, four at a time. Then they turn that ramp and they go up. Still waiting. You're waiting for that guy up there to tell you. It's amazing. We made it. Look at that. Andrew's Airway. Looks like it's getting socked in. Don't know if we're gonna be going today or not. Morning number two, we're gonna try it again. Couldn't fly out yesterday. We're gonna see if it happens today. Looks pretty good out here though. Deadman Bay cabin. They got a propane heater right there. That's the new heater. It's not the one that's on their website. And we got here, we only brought 2.5 gallons of fuel because we had to shed so much weight. And I looked in the drum, and there's about 30 gallons in the drum. We didn't need to bring any fuel. There's the drum. That's out the back window. These are the bunks. There is foam on the bunks. There's sleeping bags here. People are leaving. Nasty couch, recliner. Here's your, you got Bisquicks, buttermilk, syrups, olive oils, jellies, jams, breads, board games, first aid kits, pens, bags, Q-tips. Everybody needs Q-tips whenever they're camping. Here's a headlamp in case you need it. It doesn't work, but if you got batteries, I bet it will. Some lighters, can opener, little tool here for screwdrivers and such. Plenty of Dawn. You don't need to bring Dawn. I brought Dawn. Percolators, coffee pot. Don't need to bring that unless you're going to spike camp and want it. A couple lanterns. And here's the pantry. Pork and beans. There's toilet paper. Didn't need to bring that. There's about a half a shot left in the vodka bottle. All kinds of nails. Mac and cheese, some granola bars, Swiss Miss. You can basically just bring your gun and your hunting gear and leave the rest and just, it'll be here when you get here. There is a light there with an extension cord. If you bring a generator, it'll reach outside and you can have light. There's boot hangers, clotheslines with pulleys people have rigged up. Couple cots up there, clotheslines up there. Yeah, pretty awesome setup. So this is the inside, September 24th, 2017. I would imagine it doesn't change much. All right, we got here, got everything set up, got water, fuel in the tank. Everything pulled out that we don't need. Got our bags. He's got his freaking, I don't know, Michael Jordan's basketball shoes that he's going to the top with. And we're going to shoot through there. Possibly make spike camp overnight, so tomorrow morning we start blasting. Yep, and spend tomorrow getting stuff down if need be. Go back up, do it again. Might see a buck on the way up there. If we do, we might shoot and bring it back. We just don't know till we get there. All right, Deadman Bay Cabin hunters. Here's the beach you gotta go down in order to get to the stream. Here's the stream you gotta cross to get to the other side. You need hip boots. Or something at least comes up to your knees. Waders, whatever. We got a pair of fishing waders. We got two pair. We're gonna bring them down here, put them on, and we are then going to put them in a dry bag and strap them to one of those trees over there in hopes that a bear's not gonna come along and say, hey, what's this? And then rip them up. Might even just stick them in that tree right there since it looks like it's a little bit higher. So we went around the corner. No one has put down any logs or wood or anything. I'm not sure how in the world we managed to go this long and not already have a bridge across this thing. It could be somewhere else that we haven't seen, but the pools are anywhere from knee deep and shallower. And we're both wearing regular hunting hiking boots, so we don't want to get soaking wet prior to going to the top. So there you go. Kodiak goat hunters. This is what you're fighting through for the first 1,000, 1,500 feet. This grass.
it's just laid over grass. It gives way underneath you. And there's all kinds of cuts and holes all up underneath there for you to fall into, fall back down. So, once you get comfortable, strap your rifle to your pack. So you can continue to climb. And what doesn't look like that much, freaking go straight up. So, you can land on top, I guess. But then you're not sitting in the comfort of a cabin. And you might get weathered in for 4 or 5 days. That's what we're going through right now. And there's one thing you need to understand. Kodiak does not give you anything. Say hey. You will earn it. Here we are. Stuck in the middle of this. Sitting on muskeg. Crowberries. Trying to figure out the best way to get up there. Well, here we are. Stuck in the middle of this crap. 4 hours. We probably going about 800, 900 feet in elevation, maybe 1100, somewhere in there. That's 2400 up there. I don't think we're halfway yet, and we got to go through all that. Yep. From here, it's piece of cake. At least that's what it looks like. Kicked our butts. That's the top. Probably 2/3, you think? I'd say 2/3 of the way up. We're trying to get to there to see if we can get our tent up for the night. I can't say we didn't put in a day's work. We are up this freaking thing. Same day we flew in. Walking deer trails, bear trails. And I don't know if y'all can see all those little white spots all over there. But those are all goats. Unfortunately, they are not close. And they are down the other side of this mountain. But those are goats, buddy. I see 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 right there. Hopefully we wake up and there's some up there. And we just shoot them in the jungle now. Because I really don't want to go over there. You tired? This is a hilly bird, I believe, three-man tent. And if it's three people fitting in this thing, it's some pretty small people. But it's going to do the job for what we need because it just started raining. Yep. Here we are. Good old goat hunt. Morning of day two. We can shoot. It got cold last night up here. We got frost on the tent. And we did not plan on having freezing temps. So we were cold all night. We planned on it being 80 degrees and sunny like it is in Hawaii all the time. Beautiful morning, Kodiak, Alaska. We just spotted about 10 goats over the hill. Gustin's over there looking at them. Brush my teeth and whatnot. Put us a sneak on. This is what we're looking at. We're hoping they work their way to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
There's two more down below.
Two more down below. There's a bunch up on that hilltop right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's one over there. 8. But these right here, if they keep going to the left, those are the ones. They're going to give us a good shot. There they are.
.245 to the top.
It's a long shot. Sun's in our eyes. All right, we just made two shots. Gustin's. Oh, hang on, I'm still alive. If he gets up, I'm gonna have to ring his bell again.
I fell behind that rock. That rock. There's Cody still moving a little bit.
And he's laying down.
He's going up the hill. Heck yeah. That goat's all over the place.
Now the plan was to go ahead and whack two a piece. But after you saw what we went through yesterday,
it took us 5 hours to get up here. Beautiful day. I feel hold up.
Come on, stop like rolling, man. Is he trying to roll? He's dead. You're dead. You're on that rock.
Yeah, I'm on that rock.
Did you miss that first shot?
I don't think so. But that second shot was offhand.
Was it?
Dropped him, which I'm pretty proud of. I don't know, where was yours? In the grass right up there?
Mine was the farthest one. Almost at the top of that little rock slide above us. To the left of us.
Yeah, like 256 in that green patch, I think is where he was.
Judging from the blood spot, I still hit high.
2.6, 2.9. I'd say about 250.
I can't believe I didn't just put the video on. How did we miss that?
Yeah. I don't even have a knife on. You got a knife on?
No, we gotta go get our bags. I just want to make sure it's dead.
I'm not. I had a pretty mean quartering away from me. He's about a third away.
Well, then, mine's done. I assume yours is done. He's just laying on that rock. Now the work begins. Look at all them goats up there. Making our way in here. This is a little valley down in the bottom. We camped over that hill. My goat's right there. Gustin's up there. I guess now's the time to be praying. He didn't just get up and walk away. This is a steep mess. That would appear to be a pretty doggone good shot. That is a 300 Win Mag at 256 yards. And that thing's he does not have any ground shrinkage. And he looks heavier and heavier every step I take. And he looks wetter and wetter too. Well, he said make a double long shot, and that is a double long shot. That's a nice goat. They're under. That's a big animal. I hope I can get him out at one time. Hopefully there's a lot of guts in there. Because we got to get back up there. And then down the other side. I got just the meat on my back. It's probably 100 pounds. I'm trying to crawl out of this bowl. You can train for this all you want, but you better be a man whenever you walk up this place to get a goat. If you don't land on top, heaven help you. I'm just trying to get back to the tent. We haven't even started going back to the cabin. I just heard a gunshot. Somebody else shooting goats. Alright, we're leaving one goat. We're going to come back tomorrow and get it. We're trying to go down the night with mine. And that's a haul. We're taking down anything that we don't have to have up here. We're leaving camp. Just in case we get up here and we have to stay a night again. But we're going to try to make it down today. 6.7 miles. That's how far we walked yesterday to get to Spike Camp. So if you want to rent Deadman Day Bay cabin to come goat hunting, 6.7 miles to get to Spike Camp. Through the grass and the alders and raspberries and everything else fighting you. We're going down a different way. Hopefully it's better. But if you're from the east and you don't know what raspberry and alders means, it means thorns and scrub oaks everywhere you turn. We had to switch backs because I fell a few times. The way it was going, I was going to end up seriously injured. I got some equipment, his rifle, my rifle, and the pelt. He's got all the meat, but he is a workhorse. He's got about 50 pounds on me. We still got to get down there. Then we got to get back up there and get the other one and the camp over the next couple days. You do this hunt, you better be ready to cowboy up. And you better have ambition just as much as you have ability. Because you quit halfway through this, you may as well just lay down and die. It's our last creek to cross. Trying to get through these alders. GoPro! Justin's over there. We're trying to figure out the best way to get up the other side. This is about the fifth one we've had to cross. And they all suck. None of them are any fun. We got about an hour left daylight, hour and a half. Somewhere around probably half mile to get to the cabin. We're just trying to get there. You want to shoot a goat? No, you don't. It's just a stupid goat. Don't know if you can see them. There's a sow and three cubs chasing fish in the stream behind the cabin.
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock, they're out. She's moving our way.
It's not good.
Deadman Bay goat hunting users. Make sure you time your return right. Watch for high tide. There's the cabin. And we still can't just walk to it. Probably the most I've ever worked in my life. We had breakfast yesterday morning. We got on the plane. We had a peanut butter sandwich before we hiked out. Since then, a couple granola bars and some chewies. That's it. It's an awesome weight program, huh? Wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
All right. We're going up the second time. We came up a different way. We crossed the creek in a different spot because we can see the ridges that we need to get on now. And we just needed these to be able to cross the creek back there. But you better be yelling, letting bears know. We're going to stash our rubber boots in this section of trees. Same place we came through yesterday. We should be able to get back here with no problem. Because after you've done it one time, that's what makes sense to come back this way. So, yeah, we're starting to go up for the second goat. So for those of you that want to use the cabin, this is the first ridge that you see, and it just shoots right up to the top.
Got a mile.
And then you got to make your way over there from the top. First day we went this way, and it's a hike. There ain't no joke. It's raspberries the whole way, and I mean they just tear you up. But whenever we get to the top, we're gonna try to figure out the easiest way to get over some of these streams, because there's about three streams that run off the top as opposed to waterfalls and rivers that flow all through here. There's another waterfall, there's a waterfall, there's another waterfall over there, and you cross each one of them three or four times coming down through there. This actually has game trails going to the top. You can tell which way they've already got trails going. Right now the grass is all starting to lay down, but there's game trails going all the way to the top that you can follow. The raspberries will tear you up, but at least there's a trail. I'll do another one there we get to the top. As we watch the American hunter, hiker, traveler, adventurer in action, you realize the bugs rule the world. Alright. A little bit smarter. If you can follow the alders, follow the alders. It's easier. It's a pain in the butt going over all of them, but the water runs through them. It tells you the easiest way. You gotta switch back up and up this mountain. You just gotta switch back. That's the only way you can do it with relative normalcy, other than trying to freaking climb straight up something that's almost impossible to climb. Listen to the water. Each one of these ridges, the water's down here, and if you follow it, you see where that next ridge right there comes down and meets it. Follow it as much as you can. Go to the next ridge, switch back. That ridge comes down, meets up with this one, switch back. And then we gotta get to the edge of this hill and climb up. That's how you conquer this thing. Well, I can't say that. That's how you go up this thing. We're making much better time, and it's nowhere near as hard on us doing it this way. All right, we just cleared all the alders. We just got the last little push to get to our camp. It's right in there. It's beautiful once you're up here. In case you didn't know it, mountain goats live in the mountain. And it's up there still. This last push is kicking our butt. But we're still way ahead of the time we were the first time we came up.
Wanna leave it where you left it last time?
Yeah, probably. 7 hours to the top and done. Ready to go back to the spike camp. Still see 3 goats over there on the hill looking at us. Eagles are flying. That's the valley. Pretty awesome little valley. And I'd imagine if we were camping down at the bottom, you could probably just put this thing on a raft and float it out. But we didn't put that much thought into this. Well, we just finished up back to spike. There tomorrow. I don't know, you see any bears down there? I don't think I see anything moving. This is normal Kodiak. Luckily, we've had great weather. There's goats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They're just all up in those nooks and crannies all over that thing.
You okay?
Yeah, you okay? Boy, let's kick it out there tonight. Let's go. Have a good tent. last trek down. It's supposed to be rain and wind all day. We gotta get off this mountain and get back to the cabin. Right now we're shooting for those little ponds right down there. We're on the last ridge. We came from there about 2.5-3 hours. We made it through all that crap. We just gotta get down there, and this is the ridge, the very first ridge we come up on. By now, it should have a decent trail broken on it. Last home stretch. Just came down off that, we're back at the creek. Gonna go over there, get our waders from a few days ago. Head the beach to the cabin. So after the hunt, sitting in the cabin, we got clotheslines everywhere because we got soap coming down. It was raining the whole day. Wind was blowing. Sitting here enjoying a drink. We just had some goat rib meat and goat heart. And it was awesome. It was awesome. Yeah. Hardest hunt I've ever been on in my life, bar none. The hunt itself was easy. Getting to and from the hunt, I won't ever do that again. I'll go somewhere else where I can get closer, get dropped off and have camp. I won't come to this cabin to hunt goats again. I can guarantee you that. It's over 5 miles no matter how you look at trying to get to them. Can be as much as 7 depending on if you get sidetracked. And there's nothing easy about not 1 foot of it. So come here to enjoy the fishing, shoot deer on the beach, crabs, bear hunt. Great place to come for a bear hunt. Don't come here for a goat hunt. You're just asking somebody just to punch you in the face. So I'm enjoying my drink. And then the side. There's a freaking elk walking through the water right there. Hang on. Hang on, we'll turn it off. Alright, go ahead. Oh, that's fucking stupid. There's an elk walking through the water right there in front of the cabin. Seen the elk walking through salt water. Oh. Oh. I guess it was walking in the water safer than walking in the woods, huh? No kid. Don't have a tag for that. They got a season on them now. Well, there they are. Move that. About to get them salted. Mine's on the right. This side. Just in case you didn't know.
Last day, we're sitting here waiting on the plane to come. It's kind of foggy out there. Hopefully, it's not going to be a problem. I think they can get here no problem. I don't know about leaving where they're at. We still got about 3 hours. No, 2 hours. We're leaving trekking poles. They earned their keep. We're leaving baby wipes, trash bags, Walmart bags, toilet paper. There's a pickle if anybody wants it. There's a pickle in there. It's good. It's good till next year. Oh yeah, we're leaving 20 pounds of salt. Since we didn't get any other goats, this is the food cache and this is the tool cache. Holy crap, there's the barbecue. There is a barbecue. I was wondering why there was charcoal. So there's a barbecue grill here if you just bring some charcoal with you. What are these buckets under here? Kerosene, they're all in here. There's some paracord, tarp, more toilet paper, honey roasted peanuts. Pork and beans are good. We had those two nights in a row. We left some oatmeal. All the food was good. We didn't run into anything that was expired. Maybe a little stale, but not expired. There's your diesel stove. So your diesel stove, you turn the valve on out back. To the left is high. There's your arrow. To the right is low. The instructions say turn it on 3. But it doesn't say you gotta pull this out. So you gotta pull this out to let the fuel flow. This is already open. And if you take this grate off and you turn the heat up, if you got enough diesel, you can cook on that thing. There's two lanterns. Might want to bring some mantles. As long as you bring a thing of propane, you can use lantern. We added our contribution to the clothesline that goes all the way across so that you can lower it up there, put your clothes up on the clothesline, pull them up there and have the whole rafter drying clothes because that's where all the hot air is. There's none down here. Boot dryer's good. Beds are awesome. They all got foam pads. Somebody's got a dart board, but we didn't see any darts. Sleeping bags. Oh, I'm also leaving a couple fleece blankets. What do you think?
Here's a good cabin. Kept us dry and warm.
I think we both agreed it's the hardest hunt of our lives. And we had to shed our fishing gear because of the weight. We were right at our weight. We were still 2 pounds over coming out here, so we had to shed our fishing gear. It would have been awesome to have fishing gear to go out there and catch some fish, but it seems to be only pinkies around here. Haven't seen any deer. We saw one deer on the way up, or up top. And that was it. Seen lots of deer sign, lots of deer tracks, but not a lot of deer. One elk, one fox. One bear, either 2 or 3 cubs, one or the other. Yep. If you bring you a generator, you can plug in the light. Other than that, we got a line here to hang the lantern over the table. Or a light of some kind. Good cabin. Here's the record book. It says the stove will burn 2 gallons of fuel per day on low setting if you run it all the time. So I imagine if you run it on number one all the time, you're 2 gallons of fuel a day. All right, so here we go.
This is the best entry that I've found yet. We're going to read this because these catches, they got to be from New York or something. Mid-August 2015, Friday, arrived by seaplane. The pilot was nice enough, but he didn't have one of those pilot hats that real pilots have. Those ones with visors and the emblem, that's when you know you're safe. Saturday, Tom caught a fish down at the beach today. He pulled the fish on the shore, but none of us wanted to touch it, so we left the fish and the rod on the beach. I guess we'll have cheese and crackers tonight. Sunday, we went exploring today. We walked north along the shore, but the river was too wet to cross. We'll hike south tomorrow, but I'm not wearing my loafers again. There's a hint. Monday, rain all day, so the plane couldn't come to resupply us with a second bottle of brandy and my Argyle socks, which we left in Kodiak City, City, because we were over our 1,500-pound weight limit. That's 750 pounds more than we came with. Tuesday, ran out of bottled water and brandy last night. We followed the instructions and boiled the bay water, but it tastes terrible. We're going to try boiling it twice. Now, we're debating on whether or not they actually boiled salt water and tried to drink it, because it says bay water. But we're going to give them the benefit of the doubt that they didn't, and they just got bad water out of the pond. Wednesday, I read the Know Your Bear Facts pamphlet this morning. We all decided we should stay inside. No one went along to the outhouse. Better safe than sorry. Thursday, stayed in again, but we put up curtains made from my luggage and my street clothes on all the windows just for privacy. Who's looking through the windows? Greg is starting to mumble. I think he's had too much boiled bay water. Yeah, you boil salt water, that'll get to you. The plane comes to get us tomorrow, but I'm not ready to leave. That was the last of them. All right, we're getting picked up. Just loading everything up. It's been a good cabin. There it is. And that's where you got to go to get them. I'll go get proof in a second.
Can't see.
Gustin's is 72 pounds meat. What the?
I kicked it.
Yeah. Let's see what mine is. He ate probably 15, 20 pounds off of 105. So he probably packed down 110, 115. 177 total together. Just meat. Neither one of them are boned out though. So that's probably 10 pounds of bones off mine and 7 or 8 pounds of bones off his. Riding around the roads on Kodiak. Assessing to see what's going on. Trying to find us a deer. Trying to find us a deer. We'll find something. We got the sea otters out there playing. Eating on some mussels, swimming on his back. There's 4 or 5 over there. Finishing out just before we get on the ferry, doing some salmon fishing, trying to catch our limit of silvers, which is 1. But we can't even do that, so it really don't make a difference. Bunch of them in here, most of them look spawned out though. Last leg of the trip. Just got to Homer on the Tustamina. They're going on vacay with a wobbly wheel on their wagon. I think if I was going to roll off in Homer and go on vacay, I'd have a wagon with a good wheel.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
Why didn't y'all take the passageway? It's a foggy morning.